India is slowly getting the hang of fast cars. Just look at Mumbai, for example. You have nice cars around each and every corner. But that's Mumbai. The roads are relatively better than many cities in India, and most people in Mumbai can go for big boy cars like the M5, RS7, CLA45s, etc. But we are in Pune, which is a rather humble town compared to Mumbai, and our roads aren't as good and not everybody's filthy rich. So what do you do if you want to go as fast in a city like this?
You get yourself an Octavia VRS. This has been at the forefront of the Indian tuning scene since the longest time. And since it's a sports saloon, you can actually convince your wife that it's got four doors, it's quite practical, big boot, lot of space. And when you want to like actually take it for a hoon, it satisfies the petrol head in you too. The Octavia VRS is that you get the same engine as the Golf R you get in the West, and you also get the 6-speed DSG, which is popping fast. It pops and crackles on upshift and it burbles on downshift, which is really nice. You also get quite a lot of tech wizardry with the car, like limited slip diff, you get brake assist, electronic brake distribution, and so much more. All of that comes into play when you're actually really hooning the car and pushing the limits out of the car. And all what it does is just translates quite a lot of turning into grip, and it grips, boy.
All of these gizmos literally neutralize the understeer from this vehicle, and because of the special suspension that the VRS gets, the car corners absolutely amazing. There is tons of grip, and the limited slip diff isn't your traditional braking bias diff, but it actually monitors the grip levels of both the front wheels, and it gives the wheel which has the most grip the most power. And you can feel this tech work when you're absolutely thrashing the thing. The VRS has to be one of the most well-rounded vehicles that have been ever sold in India. Most people can argue that what fun is a front-wheel drive sedan, but that means they haven't driven an Octavia VRS.
Because those people know that real sports saloons are rear-wheel drive.
The VRS is great and all, but this is the real deal. The BMW 530D M Sport. The VRS's engine might be sporty in the literal sense because it's a 2-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder from the Golf R, but the 530D, it's no slouch. It gets a twin power turbo, inline 6, turbo diesel engine. But the real thing about this car and why it's so good and why I chose it for this comparison is because it's rear wheel drive. I mean, just think about it. Inline 6 engine, turbocharged and rear wheel drive with paddle shifters. That's a proper sports car setup. I mean, except from the diesel part.
The BMW also gets quite a lot of driver aids. It's a very similar list to the Octavia VRS's, except that you can directly understand that these systems are tuned in the BMW for luxury and safety rather than performance and grip.
When you start driving this car and you actually start pushing it, you understand why BMW has sheer driving pleasure as their motto. I mean, the steering is so responsive, it's so direct, and even though this is a diesel engine, it pulls so hard. And from time to time, you can hear the small turbo spools and blow-offs from the engine, which makes it even more fun to drive. And this is what the 530D is about. Insane highway cruising speeds and also playful in the twisties. The F10 generation of 5 Series was a more corporate looking car in my opinion. It was the type of car you would find in a large business park where the executive drives it all the way from home to work. But when you get the M Sport, things change a little. You get a M Sport bumper with M Sport wheels, which are 18 inches. You also get a M Sport style steering wheel inside. And overall, the car looks much meaner, and in this carbon black paint, it has a really nice stance. Come into the interior, and you're greeted by one of the plushest interiors in the business, at least back when it came out. I mean, it's not as fancy or as in your face like a Mercedes E-Class, and it's not even as boring as an Audi. It's just perfect. You get the M Sport steering wheel, which has paddles on it, so you can click down while driving. It has the nice gear selector over here, whereas the new gear selectors are much more fat and, you know, like they're clumsy and stuff. This is a nice sleek little one. You also get the iDrive system, and I think so this is one of the most intuitive infotainment systems you can ever get. I mean, yeah, of course the newer systems look much more sleeker. Even the VRS has a really slick touchscreen on top, but I mean, come on, while driving, this motion is much more better. Apart from that, you get this nice tan interior leather all over, and since it's the M Sport, you get some hints of M over here, like on the door sills you get an M badge, and yeah, you get an M badge over here on the steering wheel as well.
The VRS looks rather understated. There are a few hints of sportiness here and there, but overall the car is pretty much a sleeper. Now the new normal Octavia looks like a car that you would find in a business park driven by a man a few places below exec, but give it the VRS treatment, you get new bumpers, a nice spoiler, and really nice tailpipes. Now, if you thought the 530D had a good interior, well, think again. This, in my opinion, trumps the 5 Series. And when you look at it, it's really not a bad place to be. You've got these sports Alcantara bucket seats, and you've got this leather perforated sports steering wheel. And wherever you go and look around, you have this checkered carbon fiber trim. And also the plastics are very, very nice. They're all soft touch. This place is filled with tech. And the driving position is...
Both of these cars are performance bargains. Well, not the VRS really, because finding one secondhand is near to impossible. And since they were sold in such limited numbers in India, depreciation is non-existent for the VRS. The 530D was approximately a 70 to 80 lakh rupees car when it came out, and now with 2011 to 2013 models going anywhere between 15 to 30 lakh rupees, depending if it's an M Sport or not, the 530D is surely the one to have if you're looking for sedate performance. The power it gives you is effortless, and it is meant to go cross continents with ease, doing insane cruising speeds. But put it into Sports Plus mode, and then you understand why it's named an M Sport. The VRS, on the other hand, is a true and true enthusiast car. It sounds so much better than the 530D, it looks so much more purposeful, and in fact it is the one to have if you're looking for a true performance machine. All of the gizmos and sheer performance tunability of the VRS is unmatched, and is the one to have if you're a true enthusiast, even though it's front wheel drive.
After a thorough yet fun day with these two really, really interesting sports saloons, we've come to a conclusion, somewhat of a conclusion. They're very different in their own style, yet they're really similar. I mean, front wheel drive versus rear wheel drive, diesel versus petrol. However, we have come close to one similarity. Both of them are much better than SUVs. And well, I'll give you another similarity. Both of them are really fun to drive. However, the Indian market has kind of forgotten this kind of fun and have always tried to push towards SUVs. However, I still think these have a little bit of a chance, and you should give them a chance. Thank you so much for watching. This is Bhavneet signing out. Peace.